Inner Traditions Audio presents Womb Awakening, Initiatory Wisdom from the Creatrix of All Life by Azra Bertrand, MD, and Seren Bertrand, read by Aura Paige. Foreword, Linda Starr Wolf. The Word Made Flesh. These are the words that ignited the fires of my imagination as a young child, words that whispered directly into the depths of my feminine psyche. It was a coded message, a hint of a magical possibility that activated the imaginal cells within my being and gently guided me along toward my destiny. Little did I know at that time that I, a small child living in a conservative Baptist family in rural Kentucky, would one day experience a profound spiritual awakening at the hands of the Great Mother and awaken the shaman within. The Word would indeed become flesh, and in a female body, no less. It was not easy being me in that Baptist church. I innately sensed, even at a young age, that there was more to the story than I was being told. And despite scoldings, I regularly committed the mortal sin of asking too many innocent questions. I was told that if I doubted the word of God, I would go to hell and be damned for eternity. I must admit, since all the adults around me appeared to believe in these stories, the idea of having a red devil torture me with his pitchfork made me think twice. I prayed harder to have more faith and fewer questions, but still they continued. Feelings of shame, feeling different from the others and not fitting in, were a regular feature of my life at that time. Looking back as an adult, I can see that it was my wild and witchy grandmother who saved my life. She was my mother's mother, Mammy Jones, my renegade Baptist Celtic shamanic grandmother, and was my sole refuge during my early childhood years. Even though she attended church services and read the Good Book, she seldom wore shoes. She let her hair down wild and loose. She talked, joked, and laughed loudly, and was frowned upon for not being very ladylike. Mammy Jones taught me the sheer joy of being connected to the natural world, as we would take mysterious walks into the woods, share in the sensual pleasure of digging our bare feet into the rich, black, loamy soil of Mother Earth, and picking luscious fruits and vegetables from the gardens and orchard. We played in the rain, waded in the pond, gathered the still warm eggs from our chickens, and made corn maidens from the long ears of corn that grew in the cornfields. We rescued baby birds that had fallen from their nests and watched caterpillars morph into butterflies. At night, we sang songs, prayed to God, Jesus, and the fairies, all in the same breath. We asked them to bless our gardens, animals, and all those we loved. We made up rhymes and stories and told old beloved fairy tales in the dark until bedtime, swinging back and forth under a star-filled, luminous night sky. Her big heart, free spirit, unrelenting faith, and love helped me to believe in myself. She would remind me that I was special, not defective, as I often felt, even though I could see and hear things in the shamanic realms that others didn't seem to even know existed. I have written about my beloved Mammy Jones in many of my books because it was her wild womb wisdom that nurtured my young body, soul, and spirit, and that kept me fed when the world around me didn't make sense and threatened to eat me alive. She died unexpectedly, right after my 12th birthday, and just before my first moon time. So when the curse, as it was known, came to me, I didn't have anyone to turn to with my questions. My own mother was quite young herself, and was lost in deep grief and depression over the death of her mother. She gave me some sanitary napkins, some aspirin, and a hot water bottle for cramps, and didn't have much to say about any of it. I didn't even know what it was all for. After my grandmother's death, I felt tremendously alone, with no one to guide me, although I always felt her love and spirit nearby. However, the spiral path of my life wove on, taking me on many shamanic journeys of death and rebirth. Eventually, in my 30s, I fully embraced my destiny as a spirit keeper on the shamanic path of the heart, when life surrendered me into the void of the Great Mother and I let go of the normal world. I finally came back home to myself, the real self that my grandmother had so tenderly nurtured and furiously protected for the first 12 years of my life. And what a relief it was. As I stepped into my inner knowing, my shamanic spirit began to guide me into my inner depths, and I heard the voice of my own womb knowing emerging with more and more power. The wild, sensuous kundalini energy that was pouring through every cell in my body exploded within me, and the true meaning of the word made flesh blossomed in my own life. Many mysteries were revealed to me that had always been hidden just beneath the surface of my consciousness. I finally understood that the word made flesh was my spiritual journey, a journey of descent and embodiment. Our spirit, which vibrates at a high frequency, must descend into the heart of the matter so that we can fully experience what it means to be human and the incredible gifts waiting for us. What a joy it was to realize that our flesh is sacred, not sinful. Our body is the temple. I truly knew for the first time that I was not evil, and that the goddess and sacred feminine priestess were alive in my body and blood. I could see that what others had judged me for and what I had been afraid of was my own divinity, my royal birthright to become a heavenly queen on earth. Since that great time of awakening, my soul has taken me on a multitude of epic journeys filled with many shamanic and archetypal energies that have magically embodied my being, each bringing me into communion with more expansive fields of wisdom and unconditional love. When I first met the authors of this audiobook, there was an instant recognition of a soul kinship. We were traveling along the same spirit paths and creating from the same universal flow of Shakti. What I was calling awakening the shaman within was very akin to what they spoke of as womb awakening and reclaiming the feminine holy grail. We spoke together with great enthusiasm of a deep inner well of wisdom that was the portal that once opened gave access to the world's sacred mystery school's teachings. This knowledge was all held within us, including the vast library of the Akashic record. When the inner shaman awakens, and when the womb awakens, nothing can be hidden any longer. This beautifully written and intelligent audiobook, Womb Awakening, Initiatory Wisdom from the Creatrix of All Life, is born from the rich, experiential, personal journeys of two amazing lovers of truth, who were always destined to find each other and to discover sacred union within themselves as well as in each other's arms and hearts. They share the elixir of their ecstatic love as a fountain of rebirth and renewal with the thirsting soul of the world. I am honored to introduce you, the listener, to Dr. Azra Bertrand and Seren Bertrand, world travelers, researchers, mystics, and shamanic souls who have dedicated their lives to studying and living the great mysteries around the globe on both the outer planes and the inner ones. Their collective wisdom is admirable, and their commitment to awaken the forgotten and repressed passions of the womb consciousness that belongs to us all reminds one of the stories of the great Grail kings and queens of old. They are troubadours of the spirit, singing a new song into being that is so timely and important for this age. I humbly bow in reverent recognition to the power of the Word made flesh in this lovely audiobook. The lost song of songs that is once again returning as our imaginations connect with our renewed passions to recreate and rebirth the world we live in through reuniting the collective wisdom of our feminine consciousness. Preface. Love letter from the authors. Be patient. She is weaving and spinning. You cannot even begin to dream of the possibilities she is stitching into being for you. A. and S. Bertrand. Dear womb pilgrims, thank you for choosing to take this journey into the womb. Every woman who takes this pilgrimage and every man who walks with her brings an incredible blessing and boon into the world. The pilgrimage into the womb brings us deeper into life and love. We believe the collective awakening of the womb is the medicine our world needs. It is time to reclaim our creative womb power and to restore the ancient feminine cosmologies that honor the sacredness of life and help guide us to live in harmony with all of creation. The remembrance of womb consciousness is as vital to men as it is to women, as we were all created and birthed through a womb and within womb consciousness. This transformative primordial energy.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.